Welcome back, everybody, and thanks to all the new subscribers. Thank you very much for ticking the box. A bit of entertainment this time. Previously, over a year ago, I built these coaxial open baffles and did a couple of videos on these, and I wasn't overly satisfied with them, so I packed them away and I went on and used these two ways, and I've changed these 4-inch drivers. The base unit, 15-inch Eminence, hasn't changed, but I've changed these for all sorts. But anyway, I was undaunted. This is a three-way open baffle. And as you can see, I did have this compression tweeter in the back of this coaxial driver from Eminence. It's a CX, 12-inch CX, beta, I think they call it. And I was dissatisfied, completely dissatisfied. So I went on, and in the previous video, I built this horn and use this compression driver, which just happens to be a BRC 135. It's okay, but I've tried all sorts of crossover slopes, 12, 24, 47 dB slopes, and it turns out that this tweeter does not blend or doesn't sum very well with this 12-inch. So this little exercise is going to be, we'll have a listen first, but I've got a couple of Eminence 2002S's 8 ohms, which will blend very well with this 12-inch. Now the problem I have, this is a bit peaky, it's a bit shouty. I can dial it out using DSP, but I'd rather not dial it out. If I can get a natural blend or natural sum and then tweak it, that would be much better. So we're going to have a quick listen first, and then we'll come back and I'll show you what we're going to do.
How can it be that a love carved out of caring, passion by faith, but suffered so hard from the games played once too often, but making mistakes is a part of life's imperfections. Born of the years, is it so wrong to be human after all? Drawn into the stream,
there's a little sound bite, and I'm just going to excuse the motion. I'm going to take you across here, and what we're going to do, bear with me, it's all very Heath Robinson here. What we're going to do is chop out this driver. So the first thing I have to do is connect the amplifier, which I can do downstairs at the terminals. This is like that. Now we're going to just disconnect that, unscrew this, hand under the bottom. This is a cheap. I think this is about £40 each. I don't know who manufactures this. I think it might be Fane. But it's a 1-inch throated titanium little inch coil, I think. But it has an edge to it, and I think the edge is because I'm crossing this at 1.5k to try and match the 12-inch below. But this is only designed to go down to 3,500. So I'm forcing it. I'm really forcing it, and I'm tweaking the DSP to make it work. And I don't think it likes it. So what we're going to do we're going to drop in this Eminence PSD2002S 8 ohms, which I am told, reliably informed, is in a different league compared to this. This one will easily go down to 1,000, cross at 1,000 hertz, which will blend with the 12 inch below it much easier. So it's just a screw in thread. It's a bit of a pain to get in. There we go. Bear with me. Told they can be a right sob to get in. There we go. Feel it go. Fully home. Now I've got to go and get a couple of spades and put some spades on here, so I'll be back in a second. So I've just put a couple of spades on the end, crimped them up so the striped is negative and the plane is positive. So that one's in situ. I'm now going to go and do the other one. So I shall be back in a very short while. So that's both of them done now. So I'm just going to walk you back to a bit of a viewing and listening position. This might be horrendous. They're brand spanking new, so right, go and hit the button.
Let's see.
Okay, we're all in position, all wired up, everything's lovely. Let's hit the button, let's have a listen.
Same track, level 42, something about you. I haven't changed any volumes.
How can it be that a love carved out of caring, fashioned by faith, but suffered so hard from the games played once too often? But making mistakes is a part of life's imperfections, born of the years
Is it so wrong to be human after all?
Drawn into a stream.
I don't know whether you could hear any difference. I did. There's a subtlety. A bit of harshness has disappeared, or would appear to be. The fact that they're brand new, they can only get better, surely. But I'm just going to play with the crossover a little bit. I want to lower it down to match, to make sure these two units are working in unison via the DSP. That's going to take me a little while, so I'll be back shortly. Just to, for those that are interested, sorry, I'm holding this by hand. So we've got the bass, mid and the high, the tweeter. Both the 12 inch and the 15 inches are around about the 98 dB, so I'm leaving them at zero. That's the gains here. But the tweeter is very hot. It's 106 dB as a manufacturer's specification. So I'm trying to blend them just to make them all the same levels. So I've dropped that by minus 8 dB, as you can see here, just here. Crossover on this occasion, and again, this is manufacturer sort of specified. I'm coming off 400 Hz at 12 dB. So there's the slope, you can see that in orange. So the mid is from 400 Hz, 12 dB, to 1200 at 12 dB per octave, and that just fills the gap in between the two. And this tweeter comes in at 1200 here, I don't know if you can see that, at 18 dB, and again that's the manufacturer specification. So I'm doing nothing out of the ordinary here, just sort of a flat response. I will go into depth with the PEQ at a later date. I've given it a little bit of boost in the bass. But there's no trickery. I've got nothing going on here. That one there needs to be zero. That needs to be, that's it. There we go. So there's nothing spectacular going on there. Connected. As soon as I disconnect, that saves to the mini DSP, which is on the desk in front of me here, all connected. Now I've got to do that twice. Be back shortly. So as you've seen, I messed about with the crossovers as per manufacturer's instructions thereabouts. I'm going to go and hit the button and we'll have a listen.
Suffered so hard from the games played once too often, but making mistakes is a part of life's imperfections. Born of the years, is it so wrong to be human after all? I couldn't
hot in the mid.
A little bit hot, maybe 1.5-2 dB right in the middle. But I'll play around with that. But that is very listenable compared to what was there before. I don't know whether it come across on the microphone, on the camera. I've spent many hours trying to listen to YouTube videos. And they say, oh, come and listen to this. This is fantastic. I can't really tell the difference, even with quality headphones. So, but just for those that are interested, that was Tidal. We were streaming Tidal. Studio quality, I think they call it. And you can see here we're 384K. It was coming down at. And the cost terrible at this here. So it's 48K times 8 it's sampling at. It's quite nice. It sounds quite nice. I've just got to do a little bit more tweaking, but I'm very pleased with those now. That was a well worth project to get involved in. A little bit of money, a little bit of fettling. But I think I may well go ahead, probably will now, spend the money on some decent baffles. And of course you can always upgrade the tweeters again with beryllium, which are £400 or £500 a piece. But the PSD from Eminence has probably been listened to by more people across the world than anybody, any other manufacturer. So that's why I went for it really. But that's a much better result in my ears already, so it can only get better.
There's a footnote, sort of. These over here, these coaxials that I've now tweaked and tweaked and tweaked on room equalization wizard, and we got a pretty flat response, 80 dB right the way across from about, what's that, 40 hertz, something like that. I've got a sub that blends in as well, which I'm not playing with at the moment, but to give you an example, there we go, that's a tweeter. This new tweeter, the PSA2002S, is astounding. This is now 48 hours after the beginning of the video, and I left it on all night, ticking over just to burn this tweeter in, and it's got smoother and smoother and smoother. It's an absolutely wonderful thing. Quite enjoyable to listen to. So that's the tweeter, as flat as a pancake, from, they say, about 1250, and exactly right, 1250. It goes flat across, and obviously it dives off down here as they all do. But that's perfect. The CX mid-range, very good, coming on at 475 again as they specified. Drops off around about this 1250, perfect. And the 15 inch comes on a little bit bumpy, all room modes. This is, I don't bother to try and sort things off, you know, in an anechoic chamber or take it outside. This is how I'm going to listen to it. This is how I want it. And I did a little bit of tweaking here to get this to run flat. I could do with a little bit more boost here, but it's pretty flat and it sounds pretty good. So the overall response is 80 dB, pretty flat, all the way within a few dB. It's a bit wayward here, but that's room modes. But it's pretty flat all the way across. And it's very pleasant to listen to. It's very nice. I look forward to further listening sessions, and when this tweeter really does burn in, they say about 100 hours or more possibly, it really is a joy to listen to. The sparkles, the top end sparkles, even with this dive off here, it starts diving off at 10k, 14k, 16k, it dives off, but it's still very good. I can only hear to about 14. But that doesn't detract from the fact that if you can get it, I've got tweeters that go flat right the way to 40k. They seem to add something to the tonality, the nuance of the presentation. But this is a keeper for me at the moment, if she'll let me. They are a bit daunting. They do need tidying up. I've got to tidy the corner out because it's a nightmare over there at the minute. There's all sorts of cables going here, there and everywhere. This side's not so bad. So this is now some 48 hours later. The burning of these tweeters and the aftermath of the setting up via Roo and the mini DSP 2x4, getting them to balance, or to some if you like, you've seen that previously. And this is the finished, I'm very pleased with it. This is the finished sound bite, if you like. You've heard the others, you may hear a difference via this microphone on this camera, but I'm not sure. So I'm just going to go and hit the button and have a listen.
Suffered so hard from the games played once too often, but making mistakes is a part of life's imperfections. Born of the years, is it so wrong to be human after all?
Drawn into the stream.
So I'm very pleased with that. It's a much smoother presentation, more balanced, more detail, tonality is much better. A friend of mine asked me, can you tell me what kit you're using here? We were streaming that on Tidal, and Tidal via my PC, this is controlling Tidal. This device, the DAC, is controlling Tidal. And we're at 48k times 8, and we're streaming down at 384k, it's coming down at. In here, in this one, we have some Avondale SE400s. The 400 amplifiers are on the tweeters. In this one, we've got SE230s. And we have two mono SE230s here. There are monos in this case as well, this one. And there's two monos here, and this is doing the 15-inch, the bass. So that's what I'm running. The preamp is a Athena from Denafrips. Quite enjoy that. And there's this thing here is a DDC, the Iris from Denafrips. So that's what I'm using, and it's very pleasant.
Suffered so hard from the games played once too often, but making mistakes is a part of life's imperfection. Suffered so hard from the games played once too often, but making mistakes.
So I don't know how that came across, whether you could hear any difference. I certainly could hear a substantial improvement. The texture and the tonality, far more balanced sound. Nothing specific jumps out at you. It's just very, very pleasant. So hope you enjoyed that little one. Thank you very much for tuning in. And next time, what it's going to be, I don't know. It might be a gentleman's 72 playing with a name 72 preamp, I think, next time. All being well. But, well, thank you for tuning in. Stay safe, stay well, and enjoy yourselves. Enjoy the listening.